Did you give me my divorce?
Where's the paper? Here's your divorce, right here. Your half and my half.
Split the license, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Certificate.
Oh, you put it in something, didn't you?
Yeah, tell him to put it in that.
That's a good idea.
Hi, Dad. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Y'all think you know what's going on, but you don't.
No. I don't know.
Y'all think you know what's going on.
No, we're not. I bet we're pretty close.
You might be pretty close, but you really don't know what's going on.
Sweetie, don't take my picture.
Yeah, come give it here so I can take y'all's picture.
Well, we're in the light, good.
What did you?
Yeah,
he said go by the Christmas tree.
She's by the Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Oh, you got her by the Christmas tree. Okay.
Happy anniversary.
Oh, we don't need to stand here.
Give him a kiss. Aww.
The last year.
The last year?
Yep.
Yeah.
The, what do you call us running out? The,
Statute of limitations?
Statute of limitations.
Yeah.
Is it a statue or a statute?
Statue of limitations.
Ooh, man, look at that boy.
Yeah. Is him dressed? Okay.
Yeah.
They're the best man.
The best man.
What were you doing? Just smoking cigarettes?
No. Tums.
Oh, you have some Tums? I have some in there. Do you want to take some?
I got some.
Yeah. Well, you're afraid they're going to protest once the blood on. You're afraid they're going to protest. Look at that. He's trying to get mom.
That's what Daddy's thinking, you animal.
Yeah, you saw the marriage license, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Isn't that great?
I'm tearing it up, giving him half of it. That's the end.
Over.
We're going to split the certificate.
you just applied for it on the 26th, right?
No, it's we've married up there on the, up above. It was recorded down below.
Yeah, I just wanted recorded right here. Yeah,
up here says 26 too.
Yeah, that's when. Well, that's right.
It don't say 27?
No, it doesn't. Not that I see. You mean to tell me y'all been celebrating the wrong thing?
We have, haven't we?
Well, it was the 27th.
Seems to me like we do. Well, I do remember that they put the wrong date on there.
Yeah, because it says 26.
Okay. This is a surprise. You got everything?
Dad, how do you want to lock this? Do you want to go back out and come out the garage?
Come out the garage.
Well, they can get in. Do you need? I think they. Can you open this for us?
Sure. You got the camera bag?
Yeah, we got it.
I'll go out back in and come out the garage.
Well, why you want to get in so close?
I don't know.
Oh, this is cold. Oh, well, I don't know. See, I was hoping that I'd get that
door. This is your life, Lee.
Yeah.
Oh, my life. It's going by mighty fast, I tell you.
I don't know how good this is going to come out, but here's a good close-up.
I didn't know I had pink lights.
Look how nice Grandpa looks.
Yay! All right, yeah.
Yay!
Great.
Great.
Here's a good looking grandpa. It's grandma.
Come on in.
What's going on here?
Everybody's waiting.
Well, we don't know until you get here.
Yay! All
right, happy Christmas.
Thank you, darling.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas.
I Bye, you all.
That we've seen, you know, I mean, think what's happened since 1945. You've had the Korean War, you've had the Vietnam War, you had the upheaval of the 60s, you had the Watergate, you've had the Persian Gulf. I mean, and for two people to weather all that is really incredible. And I'll bet it seems like 1945 was yesterday, doesn't it, Chuck? Hard to believe.
Yeah,
it was 50 years ago. Let's go back to 1945 for a minute. Back in 1945, RKO Radio signed Boris Karloff to do a horror radio show. And Min and Ernle remember that Tupperware was invented in 1945. Since you two have been married, you've eaten 54,512 meals. Not necessarily all together. Bess Meyerson was crowned Miss America in 1945. Ray Milland, I got to read this because I wasn't here in 1945. Ray Milland wins Best Actor for The Lost Weekend. Joan Crawford was Best Actress for Mildred Pierce. Did you see that? I never saw that.
I remember the show.
Well, The Lost Weekend was the Best Picture. Cordell Hull, the Secretary of State, was awarded Nobel Peace Prize. Detroit Tigers defeated the Chicago Cubs for the World Series. Toronto Maple Leafs won the Stanley Cup. Southern Cal beat Tennessee 25-0 to win the Rose Bowl. People who were born in 1945 included Rod Stewart, Eric Clapton, Jim Davis, the guy who does Garfield, Bette Midler, Melba Moore, Tom Selleck, and Rob Reiner. 1945 was quite a year. But you know, over the year, people change and things happen to you. Lee was telling me last year on their 49th, they went out for dinner, had a good time, got back full from McDonald's, and of course, as soon as they lay down, Chuck's out like a light. She nudged him and she said, Chuck, she said, you know, 49 years ago tonight, put your arms around me. So Chuck, he sort of wakes up, rolls over, puts his arms around him. She said, now Chuck, 49 years ago, you kissed me on the cheek. Chuck, he was trying to go back to sleep. He raises up, kisses her on the cheek. He puts his head back down, he's going back to sleep. She says, now Chuck, 49 years ago, you bit me on the ear. All of a sudden, Chuck's up rooting around in the dark. She said, now, Chuck, what are you doing rooting around in the dark? He said, I'm looking for my teeth. just last week, he was going out to the store to get the lottery tickets, still hoping to get rich. And she said to him, Chuck, she said, bring me back a chocolate sundae. He said, okay. She said, now write it down, though, because I'm going to tell you what I want. I want ice cream, I want chocolate syrup, I want nuts, I want a cherry, and I want a banana. He said, I don't need to write it down. She said, no, write it down, you'll forget. He said, no, I'm not going to write it down. I know it's in a chocolate sundae. She said, no, Chuck, write it down. You'll screw it up otherwise. I know you will. He said, no, I'm not going to write it down. I know what I'm going to get. So about an hour and a half later, Chuck comes back. He's got a bag. He hands it over to her. And she looks in the bag. There's a hot dog on a bun with ketchup. She looked at him. She said, I knew you'd screw it up. You forgot the mustard. So people change and times change, and it's really incredible that you two have weathered these 50 years. And everybody here is here to see if you'll actually exchange these vows over again, and not knowing what you know. So why don't you two step out and face each other for just a second? Look at each other, because they want to see you, not me.
What if I say no?
Of course, all of you are here because this is, you all are special to Chuck and to Lee in many different ways, and having you here makes this even more special for them. And of course, I guess I better ask if anybody knows of any legal reason why these two shouldn't be here.
We don't have that.
Those of you who sent in objections in writing, we'll read them later. Everybody else, go back out the front door or around behind the front.
Right.
Chuck and Lee, are you prepared to take the vows freely and voluntarily without any hesitation or reservation whatsoever?
Yes, sir.
Of course, you understand that the commitment you make here today is intended to be a lifelong one. I think you guys probably got that part down, don't you?
We're probably going to make a go of it yet.
In a book called The Prophet, Khalil Gibran wrote a little bit about marriage, and I think a lot of what he said certainly has been evidence in your life. I'd like to read to you from it and ask that you consider his thoughts as we prepare to take the vows. Almitra spoke again and said, what of marriage, Master? And he answered, saying, you were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. Aye, you shall be together, even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness. Let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of your love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your soul. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each of you be alone, even as the strings of a lute are alone, though they quiver with the same music. And give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping. For only the hand of life can contain your hearts. And stand together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow. Chuck and Lee, I know that your marriage has given you both the opportunity to grow together, and all of us here hope that that your joys will indeed be doubled and that your burdens will always be halved by your marriage. I guess it's inappropriate for me to tell you two not to expect perfection from each other like I tell the young couples when I marry them. Remind them that everybody's human and that we all do make mistakes. And I guess the key to a good marriage is not making the same mistake over again, huh? Do it one time and learn from it. I hope that your knowledge becomes wisdom as it already has, and that your wisdom enhances both your love and your concern for each other as we all can see that it has. Above all, I hope you'll always take time to communicate it. I think if you were to share your secret with everybody, the one thing that gets all marriages through the tough times is the ability to talk to each other and keep the lines of communication open. Chuck, will you take Lee to be your wife, promising to be loving and giving as long as you both shall live? You promise to care for her, learn with her, share her dreams, and stay by her always? Lee, do you take Chuck to be your husband, promising that you'll be loving and giving as long as you both shall live? Promise to care for him, to learn with him, to share his dreams, and stay by him always. Do you all have rings?
Oh, they have rings. Thank you.
I want you to look at your rings for just a moment. Notice that they're round, completely round. They don't have either a beginning or an end. Of course, all of us here are so happy that that's how your love for each other has always been and how we hope it continues to be, without beginning and without end. But think for a minute, too, if you took a little piece out of each of the rings, they'd form a letter C. Me and Ernie, of course, immediately think of the Chicago Cubs and the Chicago Bears. But there are a lot of words that begin with C that have a lot to do with good marriages. Concern, cooperation, commitment, as evidenced by your 50 years together, and above all, communication. If you talk to each other, anything can be worked out. Chuck, if you take the ring and place it on the third finger of Lee's left hand, and as you do, repeat after me. I, Chuck, take you, Lee.
I, Chuck, take thee, Lee.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have to hold from this day forward.
To have to hold from this day forward.
You've done this before, haven't you? For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness or in health.
In sickness or in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
And forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
If you take the ring and place it on your finger of Chuck's left hand, repeat after me. I, Lee, take you, Chuck. Be my lawful wedded husband. To have to hold from this day forward. For better or for worse. In sickness or in health. For richer or for poorer. Forsaking all others. I'm not done with the ring yet. One other thing. It's a special one.
No, you give it to Mom.
That's for you.
Thank you.
the center on.
Wow.
Whoa. That's from his bride.
Mickey Mouse. Wow.
Mickey Mouse. Yeah. Mickey Mouse.
I'll take the links off for you, Grandpa.
Yeah, we have to make it smaller. Thanks. Chivalry! Chivalry! Chivalry!
race again.
Okay. Oh, you going too?
Yeah, we going too. We're all heading the same direction.
Yeah, that's true. Well, thank you so much for coming. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for asking us. And just if there's anything we can do when you're in New Orleans and not coming this way.
Thank you. And same here, for sure.
Bye, Donnie.
Bye. Nice to see you again. Yeah, bye-bye.
I saw a picture of there. You were sitting in the aircraft.
Oh.
About 10.
Oh, really?
Family. I'm running out of battery.
Every time he's not as blonde as he used to be.
No, he's a little more gray.
Yeah, a little more whiter.
That's what I remember him being.
Bye, everybody. Good to see you.
We're going to get together.
All right, good.
You too.
Hi, guy.
Hi, guy.
We just sort of looked at the call and take pictures of the battery, would you?
I felt like I was in the West.
Huh?
I felt like I was in... Hi, Margie!
Hi, Margie!
Odie! They got away.
Hi, guy!
Who got away?
Odie and the B&B.
Are they going?
What is all that noise, huh?
I can't see. Bye, y'all. Thanks. Bye. Yes, for sure.
We'll go fishing one day. We might have to play computer one day, too. I can't get it. We'll get it.
Take care, everybody.
All right.
See you.
Hey. Hey. I see you.
Oh, good. All right.
Y'all gonna have John Lee almost as a neighbor, huh?
Yeah. You'll be too close.
Bye, Laura. Thank you so much. Thank you. Yeah, we definitely. Where are y'all headed now?
We're going to Houston, hopefully maybe Beaumont or Lake Charles.
Well, where are y'all gonna spend New Year's Eve?
We haven't decided yet.
You haven't decided?
Yeah. Always go out of town, but this may have been all out of town New Year's.
Well, y'all all just stayed on New Year's.
Yeah. You're already out of town. Though.
Yeah, right.
Ray and I, we were not stopping at going on this other trip, or if I wasn't, I should say.
We would just stay for a few minutes.
Yeah. Oh, would you?
Yeah.
We've got people down below here at La Pryor that I wanted to visit with, that we didn't get to.
I'll be darned.
And it's ironic. I didn't get to visit with these people, who is the mother, but the daughter, when we go to Denver next week,
uh-huh.
I'm going to visit with her.
I'll be darned.
So we'll, you know, we get to visit the other one.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's great.
Y'all
going to
get as far as Houston tonight, you think? Beaumont. You know, Beaumont's called Stomping.
Oh.
That's right. Oh. I remember that.
Back out again.
Hey, does everybody know how to get out of here?
Yeah.
Are we all gonna be lost again?
We're all gonna go out like we came in, completely lost.
You mean my directions were that bad?
Hey, I'll be like Oshkosh, Wisconsin.
I thought all you flyers. I thought all you flyers wouldn't have a hard time finding anything.
You always had a hard time finding anything.
Have you? Bye, y'all. Take care. Be careful. Thanks.
Bye.
There you go.
That's a good positive attitude.
All right.
Oh, whoa.
was the best.
That was
ever.
The best of it.
Bye. Bye.
Oh, okay.
Got used.
The best of two days.
She was brand new and got used.
Oh, isn't that cute, really? That is sweet.
Bye.
Know what? Oh, yeah.
Get his foot in it about all. Hey, oh, you're MG.
When Margie,
he don't bark much. Does he?
Let me. Did I ever tell you about that MG? The first MG she bought. She had a picture. She said, "This is what I'm going to buy." I said, "Well, Margie." I said, "The only way I can ride on the thing is if you put a saddle on." So I says, okay. Anyway, she drives up with it, little red MGB, and she's got a saddle strapped to the luggage rack.
Bye-bye, lady.
Oh, you did. Yeah, she got a
saddle. That was cute.
Strapped in the luggage rack. And I said, what the heck are you up there? She said, well, you said you wouldn't ride it. I said, put a saddle on it. And I said, well, where'd you get the saddle? She said, I bought it. I said, you didn't buy the saddle. She said, oh, yeah, well, she actually borrowed it.
Been driving up somebody.
But she had me believing she bought that thing. You know, I was trying to hold my cool.
Hi, Gary. You're gonna have your picture?
She went all the way to Gretna, wouldn't stop. Drove all the way down here. I'm sitting on the thing, and she's running down the middle. Downtown Gretna, run all up in there and all around. And I said, stop this thing, stop this thing. And
I said goodbye to everyone else.
Well, where are you going?
I'm going to Houston. That's
good. He's waving at you. He's waving at you.
You waving at me, Derek?
Is Camino's still a plant box down there on the farm or wherever it is?
Well, he sold it to
the first day I met you, and you never got any worse or never any better.
I hate to admit that I'm no worse off for having known you. Bye, thank you so much for coming. I appreciate it so much. Thank you for coming. Oh God, I'm so glad it worked out for you. Thank you. And you have a good trip. Be careful.
I don't know.
Look,
y'all gonna be moving for a while.
Maybe we can see each other more.
We got a big house.
Yeah,
with extra rooms and all that kind of stuff.
We come down to eat. We won't stay. We come down to eat. That's what we're doing.
That's what you like doing.
Yeah,
that's
what I do best.
Daddy, you didn't rewind this tape or anything. I'm not taking over the. What? Okay, good. I didn't want to be taking over the pictures last night like we did Ginger's that time. Bye, y'all. He won the furthest prize.
I guess so.
Remember all of it.
Sure, I bet y'all had some of
it. What's it doing? What's doing?
Hi, Derek. Hi, Derek. Hi, Derek. Okay.
What? Oh! Oh!
He's looking. Telephone.
That mailbox has been torn. So, yeah. Somebody hit that mailbox?
Looks like it.
No, not here.
But nobody from here.
Well, that was already like
did it.
Oh. And after I hit it, that's the way
it was. We're going to have to assess the damage when everybody leaves. But don't
our mailbox used to be over here.
Oh, okay. Well, let's see.
I'm going to sue you anyway. I wouldn't use your bathroom a while ago. The black commode. The shower curtain's down. Spread out. Looks like wallpaper. And I'm leaning against the wall. I fell in the bathtub. Start to take a bath. Well, I'm here, I might as well, you know, make the best of it.
No, I've already paid for somebody's damage. My daughter, she broke her foot.
Yeah.
Was she here?
Are they going to pay?
Yeah.
Good.
It's an accident.
Good, it was an accident.
I wanted pain and suffering, too, though.
Hey, that would be worth about $500,000.
At least.
Yeah, you get it. You grabbed the scale, she kicked the scale. We're going to have to go.
Go get him, Derek. Go get him.
Go get him.
Here he comes.
Get him, Derek.
He's going to get him from behind. He's
going to
sneak a shot.
Get him.
You got him? Do it again.
One, two, three. Go get him.
Go get him.
Go get him. Hurry.
Whoa.
He lost his glasses.
Yay! He's sneaking up on you again.
Thank you.
Too much glare. That's Henrietta and I. Yeah, Worst Fest, 1975. She sent that picture as kind of a little memory thing. That's the chief, Colonel Kelly, Hilliard F. Kelly. He was a commander when I was there at the Naval Air Station in New Orleans. Jake and Esther sent this picture to me as a memory item. That's when I videoed Misty's and William's wedding. They took a picture of me doing it. Now, this is a book that Bob Quitsow made up for me of our times at New Orleans. That's the C-119 aircraft. That's one of our aircraft at New Orleans, actually. In fact, I'm flying that airplane. I'm taking the picture of that C-130. I'm strapped in on the back of the cargo ramp. Forget who was flying the aircraft, but I wasn't flying that day. Turn the page here. That's Quentin Dawson up there in a C-130. That's myself and Rayburn, and you can just barely see Ruffin over to the right side there, pushing Tony Duplessis into a C, correction, a B-17. We were at, we were at Savannah Air Force Base, Hunt Savannah Air National Guard Base, on a 2 weeks tour. Can't remember the year. It was in the 60s, though. He also sent this picture of when we recruited Donnie into the 926. I was the one that swore him in. Another picture of a C-130 over the Louisiana swamps. Looks like he's coming in on the drop zone. That's Al Fisher up there in the right corner. That's John D. Laney there. That's Benton Landry. He was our simulator man there at the Naval Air Station. This was our lunch group. Donald Hill on the right. There's Jan. And then Parker, Bob Knight, Andy Chaplin, and you can just barely see there, Marion Dias, and yours truly right there. Might have been eating Parker's kidney stew. Yeah, one of our get-togethers in the hangar. I see Marion to the back to us on the left, myself at the table there, probably eating crawfish. And let's see, there's Andy on the right side of the picture. Looking through this video, I can't pick up and recognize any other people. That's Jan. There's Margie on the right. Margie Lee. Margie Lee Toller now. Down here, there's Lewis Reese on the left, and Marion Dias on the right. Got to turn this up here. That's Ed Bottom. That's Otis Bentley. And that's a reproduction of the Pelican platter there when we had that gear up landing. Myself on the left there, Sid Cedar, Lou Gibson, and Rayburn. Bill Rayburn. On the left there, upper left, is Colonel Kelly pinning a medal on Milton Ferguson. And the man next to him is, his name's White. And there's Bob Quitsow to the right of him. On the bottom row, starting on the left, is Charlie Smith, J.B. Cobb, Tony Duplessis, and myself. We're all getting pinned the Combat Ready Medal on us. That was the occasion. Roy Cleveland. And then on the bottom here, there was a lot of golfers there. Colonel Kelly there, driving the go-kart. And that's Lou Staunton, the one that committed suicide. And that was the end of that. And that was from Bob Quitsow, made up that book for me. Ed Bottom sent me these pictures here. I'll see if I can name them starting on the left. That's Tony Duplessis, C.J. Perrone, the dead. Can't come up with that name. Can't come up with that name. Willie Hills, Donald Hill, Ed Bottom, and Alex Kelly. They're on the ramp there at the hangar at the Naval Air Station. This is when Ed Bottom and Tony went to Germany with the unit in 85. This is them in Munich there at the Glockenspiel. There's Tony and George Sardis. I think he went on that trip with them too. And they took a picture here of Tony, the significance being some of those Germany towns there. He was on bombing raids over them. Another shot of Tony in the area in Munich. And Ed Bottom sent me those pictures. Norris Kramer sent me a picture in some of his memories. A lot of us have got that white hair with that wide part on top, I noticed. I mentioned that to a few folks. Here's some Jake and Esther made up for us. Some of our pictures that we had took down at our camp on the intercoastal down there. We call it Fantasy Island. There's Johnny Bell, Jake. Wanda is between me and Jake back there. That's Misty and William on the left. Correction, I think that's Justin. No, it's William. That's Kelly and her rabbits. It must be me there above right. And Lee went down to the island one time. That's her fish she caught. Very nice from Jake and Esther. This is from Donnie and Cookie. It's hard to get out of the glare. I have to move off to the side. Already got her picture in it. Your green eyes with their soft lights. Your eyes that promise me a fool wearing my love. This came from Davy and Paula and the girls, and Carl. This came off the top of the cake. Thought I better take a shot of that. Shot here of what John Laney and Jerry Laney from Tulsa, Oklahoma at the moment, they gave us this, I want to say silverware, but it's gold flatware. Very nice gift.
I can tell you to
Oh,
okay.
Because I talked to Judy and I thought that we were going to.
Here comes that time.
I walk up and say, oh, do you have a ticket?
I know.
This is private for you. Can I see you?
Let me talk to Judy.
Okay, I'm pretty drinking.
Oh, come on.
Judy, here comes the judge. Get that turn.
Thank you.
is a really auspicious occasion, and it's a real honor for me to be here to re-perform a ceremony. I'd like to meet the person that did it the first time, because they did a heck of a job for the last 50 years, and go through what the turbulent times that we've seen. You know, I mean, think what's happened since 1945. You had the Korean War, you had the Vietnam War, you had the upheaval of the 60s, you had the Watergate, you had the Persian Gulf. I mean, and for two people to weather all that, it's really incredible. And I'll bet it seems like 1945 was yesterday, doesn't it, Chuck? I don't believe it was 50 years ago. Let's go back to 1945 for a minute. Back in 1945, RKO Radio signed Boris Karloff to do a horror radio show. And Min and Ernold remember that Tupperware was invented in 1945. Since you two have been married, you've eaten 54,512 meals. Not necessarily all together. Bess Meyerson was crowned Miss America in 1945. Ray Milland was, I gotta read this because I wasn't here in 1945. Ray Milland wins Best Actor for The Lost Weekend. Joan Crawford was the Best Actress for Mildred Pierce. Well, The Lost Weekend was the Best Picture. Cordell Hull, the Secretary of State, was awarded Nobel Peace Prize. Detroit Tigers defeated the Chicago Cubs in the World Series. Toronto Maple Leafs won the Stanley Cup. And Southern Cal beat Tennessee 25-0 to win the Rose Bowl. People who were born in 1945 included Rod Stewart, Eric Clapton, Jim Davis, the guy who does Garfield, Bette Midler, Melba Moore, Tom Selleck, and Rob Reiner. 1945 was quite a year. But you know, over the year, people change and things happen to you. Lee was telling me last year on their 49th, they went out for dinner, had a good time, got back full from McDonald's. And of course, as soon as they lay down, Chuck's out like a light. She nudged him and she said, Chuck, she said, you know, 49 years ago tonight, you put your arms around me. So Chuck, he sort of wakes up, rolls over, puts his arm around him. She said, now Chuck, 49 years ago, you kissed me on the cheek. Chuck, he's trying to go back to sleep. He raises up and kisses her on the cheek. He puts his head back down. He's going back to sleep. She said, now Chuck, 49 years ago, you bit me on the ear. All of a sudden, Chuck's up, rooting around in the dark. She said, now Chuck, what are you doing rooting around in the dark? He said, I'm looking for my teeth. Lottery tickets, still hoping to get rich. And she said to him, Chuck, she said, bring me back a chocolate sundae. He said, okay. She said, now write it down, though, because I'm going to tell you what I want. I want ice cream, I want chocolate syrup, I want nuts, I want cherry, and I want a banana. He said, I don't need to write it down. She said, no, write it down, you'll forget. He said, no, I'm not going to write it down. I know it's in a chocolate sundae. She said, no, Chuck, write it down. You'll screw it up otherwise. I know you will. He said, no, I'm not going to write it down. I know what I'm going to get. So about an hour and a half later, Chuck comes back, he's got a bag, he hands it over to her, and she looks in the bag, there's a hot dog on a bun with ketchup. She looked at him, she said, I knew you'd screw it up, you forgot the mustard. So people change and times change, and it's really incredible that you two have weathered these 50 years. And everybody here is here to see if you'll actually exchange these vows over again, not knowing what you know. So why don't you two step out and face each other for just a second? No, look at each other because they want to see you, not me. Chuck and to Lee in many different ways, and having you here makes this even more special for them. And of course, I guess I better ask if anybody knows of any legal reason why these two shouldn't be here. Those of you who sent in objections in writing will read them later. Everybody else, go back out the front door or around behind the front door. Chuck and Lee, are you prepared to take the vows freely and voluntarily without any hesitation or reservation whatsoever? First, you understand that the commitment you make here today is intended to be a lifelong one. I think you guys probably got that part down. There's a... In a book called The Prophet, Khalil Gibran wrote a little bit about marriage, and I think a lot of what he said certainly has been evidence in your lives. I'd like to read to you from it and ask if you consider his thoughts as we prepare to take the vows. Almitra spoke again and said, "What of marriage, Master?" And he answered, saying, "You were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. Aye, you shall be together, even in the silent memory of God. But let there be spaces in your togetherness. Let the winds and the heavens stand between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of your love. Let rather be a moving sea from the shores of your soul. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together, and be joyous, but let each of you be alone, even as the strings of a lyre alone, till they quiver with the same music. And give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping. For only the hand of life can contain your heart. Stand together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow. Secondly, I know that your marriage has given you both the opportunity to grow together, and all of us here hope that that your joys will indeed be doubled and that your burden will always be halved by your marriage. I guess it's inappropriate for me to tell you two not to expect perfection from each other like I tell the young couples when I remind them that everybody's human and that we all do make mistakes. I guess the key to a good marriage is not making the same mistake over again, huh? Do it one time and learn from it. I hope that your knowledge becomes wisdom as it already has, and that your wisdom enhances both your love and your concern for each other as we often see that it has. Above all, I hope you'll always take time to communicate it. I think if you were to share your secret with everybody, the one thing that gets all marriages through the tough times is the ability to talk to each other and keep the lines of communication open. Chuck, will you take Lee to be your wife, promising to be loving and giving as long as you both shall live?
I will.
You promise to care for her, to learn with her, share her dreams, and stay by her always?
I will.
Lee, do you take Chuck to be your husband, promising to be loving and giving as long as you both shall live? Promise to care for him, to learn with him, to share his dreams, and stay by him always. You all have rings? I want you to look at your rings for just a moment. Notice that they're round, completely round. They don't have either a beginning or an end. Of course, all of us here are so happy that that's how your love for each other has always been, and how we hope it continues to be, without beginning and without end. But think for a minute, too, if you took a little piece out of each of the rings, they form a letter C. Me and Ernie, of course, meeting the name of the Chicago Bears. But there are a lot of words that begin with C that have a lot to do with good marriages. Concern, cooperation, commitment, as evidenced by your 50 years together, and above all, communication. Talk to each other, anything. Chuck, if you take the ring and place it on the third finger of Lee's left hand, and you should repeat after me. I, Chuck, take you, Lee.
I, Chuck, take thee, Lee.
Be my lawful wedded wife.
Be my lawful wedded wife.
We have to hold from this day forward.
Having you hold from this day forward.
You've done this before. For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
In sickness or in health.
In sickness or in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
And forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
If you take the ring and place it on the third finger of Chuck's left hand, repeat after me. I, Lee, take you, Chuck. Be my lawful wedded husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better or for worse. Sickness or in health. For richer or for poorer. Looks like you know all of us. We're not done with ring yet. One other. It's a special one.
No, you give them
up. That's for you. I didn't buy it from
anybody else. Those who can't. can't see, it's an anniversary.
Happy anniversary. Thank you.
I've never been on display like this too long. I'm always behind the camera.
That's the cake.
That's the cake.
Oh, wait,
the
cake. Wait.
Where'd you go?
Keep drinking.
Now we drink.
Okay, now you really cut the cake.
Now we cut the cake.
Mike, it's your camera.
That night. Where'd she go?
Watch it.
You're gonna play me out.